You were sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy. You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy. You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Amen. Let us pray. O God, who for the glory of your name and the salvation of souls, bestowed on the priest of the St. Lawrence of Brindisi a spirit of counsel and fortitude, grant, we pray, that in that same spirit we may know what must be done, and through his intercession bring it to completion. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Micah. Shepherd your people with your staff, the flock of your inheritance, that dwells apart in a woodland in the midst of Carmel. Let them feed in Bashan and Gilead, as in the days of old, as in the days when we came from the land of Egypt. Show us wonderful signs. Who is there like you, the God who removes guilt and pardons sin for the remnant of his inheritance? Who does not persist in anger forever, but delights rather in clemency, and will again have compassion on us, treading underfoot our guilt? You will cast into the depths of the sea all our sins. You will show faithfulness to Jacob and grace to Abraham, as you have sworn to our fathers from days of old. The word of the Lord. Our response is, Lord, show us your mercy and love. You have favored, O Lord, your land. You have brought back the captives of Jacob. You have forgiven the guilt of your people. You have covered all their sins. You have withdrawn all your wrath. You have revoked your burning anger. Lord,
Jesus was speaking to the crowds, his mother and his brothers appeared outside, wishing to speak with Jesus. Someone told him, "Your mother and your brothers are standing outside asking to speak with you." But he said in reply to one who told him, "Who is my mother? Who are my brothers?" And stretching out his hand to his disciples, he said, "Here are my mother and my brothers. For whoever does the will of my heavenly Father is my brother and sister and mother." The Gospel of the Lord. There are two things you can contemplate in the Gospel today, and I don't know how you can put them together, so I'll just leave them apart. First, in the Gospel, we often imagine Jesus as the son of Joseph and Mary. Do you think he ever says to his mother? I don't know. In the Gospel today, and this happens a number of times, it says his mother and his brothers are outside and they want to speak with Jesus. And what's his response? "Who is my mother and my brother?" And he gives him that answer that anyone who believes in the Lord is a brother and sister. There was another time, remember, when Mary said they were going to feast the kingdom. She said, "They're out of wine." Remember what he said to her? "What business of mine is that?" When they looked for him in the temple, found him 3 days later, what does Jesus respond to them? "Why are you here?" His response is, "Why are you here in my Father's house? This is where it's supposed to be." I think if I said that to my mother, she smacked me with 2 flights. It's interesting, these things that Jesus says, it's because the Gospel is, and the good news is much, much more than just his particular family, but everyone is included in that family. In the first reading, I'm not going to say to all of you, but I know in my own life, there are things that I wish I had never done. There are some things in my life, no matter how many times I've confessed it, it still seems to be there. It doesn't seem to go away. In fact, the older you get together, the more you think about some of the dumb things you've done. Now, the good news, in the first reading today, it's talking about God's forgiveness. In fact, the response is, "Lord, show us your mercy and your love." Now, think about this. Each one of us has probably seen the not once, a couple times in the movie of the Titanic. Remember when it sank, it is in such deep water that human beings cannot go down there unless they're one of those submersible submarines where it holds about 1 or 2 people. The pressure of the water is so bad, it would just kill a person instantly. And yet, the water in which the boat, the Titanic, sits in is really not in the deep water in the ocean. There are places in the ocean that are deeper than the highest mountain on earth is high. There are places that no one has ever been in the ocean, most likely will never be there. They have no idea what's down there. It's so dark, it's so cold, it's so deep. If you went that far, you'd just be crushed and become a pancake. In the Gospel today, think about the time you confessed whatever it was that really bothered you. What did the Lord do with that sin whenever you confessed it? He forgave it, and where did the first reading say he put it? Not in his book. Remember I said the other day, the book is for the deeds you do good. Where does God put our sins? The prophet Micah says this, St. John's Gospel, where John reports the same scene, but then he says it differently. He says, "Behold, the Lamb of God who takes away the sin of the world." No X, just one sin. What's the one sin? Each one of us are guilty of this. It is hard to believe that God could forgive everything I have done. It's hard to believe that, but that's what the reality is. At times we feel so wonderful, but then at times that sin always seems to want to jump back and get you. But it can get you because we have to remember where it is. It is at the bottom of the sea. And when you and I face the Lord's last judgment, where is that sin still going to be? At the bottom of the ocean. That's not going to be part of our love with the honor, remember with you, whatever. So take heart today. The Lord is kind and merciful. He truly is. And his mercy shows us love. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For as on the festival of St. Lawrence of Brindisi, we bid your church rejoice, so too you strengthen her by the example of his holy life, teach her by his words of preaching, and keep her safe in answer to his prayers. And so in the company of angels and saints, we sing the hymn of your praises as without end. Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. Amen.
Therefore, as we celebrate
firstborn, we pray for every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, you may always be free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope of the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, peace I leave you, my peace I leave you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
Amen.
Let us offer each other a sign of peace. may partake of the heavenly table, Almighty God, confirm and increase strength from on high, and all who celebrate the feast day of Blessed Brindisi, that we may persevere in integrity, the gift of faith, and walk in the path of salvation you trace for us, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
May
Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go with peace.